This tutorial will demonstrate how to simulate topo cloning in SnapGene. You can simulate three variations of topo cloning in SnapGene: TA, Blunt, and Directional. To begin with, go to Actions, Topo Cloning, and select the desired variation from the submenu. For each topo cloning variation, the setup is very similar. In the new window, the first step is to select your insert fragment. If you already have a sequence file open in SnapGene before opening the topo cloning window, this will be set as the source of the insert. However, if you prefer to use a different file to specify the fragment, you can use the drop-down menu to either open a recently viewed file or another file on your computer. Next, select the desired region for insertion. To do this, you either switch to the sequence view and highlight a region of interest, or go back to the map view and select a feature. The second step is choosing a vector. Switch to the Linearized Vector tab to specify your vector. You can either select a custom file you have saved on your computer, or choose from the list of commercially available files within SnapGene. The final step is designing primers. Switch to the Product tab and select Choose PCR Primers. In the new window, adjust the desired target melting temperature for the PCR primers, and once happy with these settings, click Choose Primers. Now let's look at the output for Topo TA cloning. In the preview window at the bottom, you will see the populated fragment and product sequences. Since TA topo cloning uses a TAC polymerase with template independent terminal transferase activity, a 3' adenine overhang will be added to the fragment. This overhang binds with the thymine overhang present on the linearized vector without the need to DNA ligase. When simulating directional topo cloning, the preview window will look slightly different. This is because the forward primer includes a 5' CACC motif, which is required to ensure directionality. If your fragment already has a 5' CACC motif present, there is no need to add this to the forward primer. In this case, you can switch to the Fragment tab and select the Use directly as the fragment option. Finally, let's look at the output for blunt topo cloning. As the name suggests, you will see a blunt end fragment fused with a blunt end linearized vector. Moving on, you can switch to the Sequence tab to view and confirm the fragment is in the correct orientation. To adjust the orientation of the fragment, use the arrows at the bottom. You can also see the primer sequences and their binding regions on this screen. If you need to add nucleotides to the primer sequences, such as to ensure the fragment is in frame with the vector backbone, then switch back to the Fragment tab. You can manually edit the primer sequences using the bottom boxes. It's also possible to rename the primers here if you wish. Once you are happy with the simulation, switch back to the Product tab. You can select to save the intermediate fragment sequence following PCR as a separate file in the panel to the right. And when performing either TA or blunt topo cloning, there is also the option to save a file with the components flipped. Since TA and blunt topo cloning are non-directional, SnapGene will create two products, one that contains the fragment in the forward orientation and another with the fragment reversed. Finally, rename the product file containing the unflipped fragment at the bottom and press clone to simulate the cloning process. SnapGene will open a separate product file along with a PCR fragment and alternative product file if you select to have them. Switch to the Primers tab to view the primer sequences for this cloning process. And select the down arrow next to the Save button and choose Export Primer Data to export these sequences for easy ordering. Next, select any additional data to export and click OK to save the file on your computer. For more SnapGene tutorials, visit snapgene.com.